Hearty welcome, dear Simon, to our newest episode of Ask the Founder. So there are many, many, many people talking about Web2, Web3, Web4. Not everyone knows what it really means. So perhaps you can explain the newest thing that's on the world, Web4. What does it mean in the future multiverse? Web4 in the future multiverse, what are the advantages? Can you explain that to us? Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for today's interview, Stefan, as always. Briefly summarized, what is Web4 in general? So everyone speaking about Web4 basically is referred to as the Web4 is the so-called intelligent web, or let's say the symbiotic web that basically converges all the most, let's say, advanced technologies, means AI, the so-called IoT, of course, or the Internet of Things with blockchain, and in a 3D and VR environment. And everyone's talking about it, but everyone's also saying it's in development still. And the goal is to build this so-called Web4 in a way that is intuitive and that is easy to use. But everyone's saying this is an ongoing process. This is nothing that is already known for being already established. And for everyone who wants to learn more about the Web4, they can go to our guidebook and we will fill in many of information that you can dive into and that you can learn more about what the Web4 is in general. And in our case, how we have built the Web4 or what we have built with our platform is exactly that, what everyone is talking about. Because what we've built is scalable, multidimensional platform solution where we converge 3D and VR technology on our Future Expo, an exhibition that is online 24/7 through the browser, through the internet, accessible from any end device, means from a laptop, from a computer, from a smartphone, from a VR glass, but not necessarily, you don't have to own a VR glass, but you can use it. And then as the next part, also gaming consoles, if you want, so you can join with your PlayStation, with your Xbox, so basically from any end device, and you can access this platform through the browser 24/7. It's AI integrated, hyper-realistic 3D VR environment, and blockchain integrated, and it's truly decentralized. Means you can actually own your own data and you can manage your own data and you can disconnect your own data at any time you want. This is something, for example, that also has not been implemented and done in that way, where you can own your own avatar, you can own your own store, your own shop, your own custom environment. You can be a government that is connecting its an entire national economy, let's say a hyper-realistic rendering of the entire nation, to this platform and also disconnected at any time. And everyone who wants to travel to this country, for example, or to a specific land plot on the exhibition, they can just search for a specific location in this entire future multiverse and they can just jump there within a second. So wherever you are, you can go to any point in space-time on this platform and you can just jump there within a second. Let me give a practical example. We have built a solution where we are making the so-called Web4 accessible in the most easy and intuitive to use, practical and tangible way so that anyone can use it. This means governments can use it, companies can use it to showcase their offerings, and agencies, individual agents, they can, or any individual with an affiliate link, they can send a link to someone, for example, through Telegram or through WhatsApp or through WeChat. And then this person can click on this link and then they, with an avatar, either they already own their own avatar or with the avatar of the person who invited them or from a, let's say, a representative sample avatar from that company, they can jump to the place they were invited to and join a meeting. They can go into a shop or a store or to a safari in Africa or whatever within a second. And then basically, if they want to, they can walk around for a certain either limited amount of time, or somebody gave you, for example, gifted you a day pass, for example, that for a whole day you can walk around. Or if you were only invited for 10 minutes, buy a day pass or a week pass or a monthly membership. And then basically you have full access. You can create your own hyper-realistic avatar and then basically travel through the platform and engage, etc. But you can also, if you have created your own avatar and you're storing it on your own hardware device that we're building and that we can provide to you, then you can disconnect yourself at any time also, and you're fully owning your own data. Now, let me give an example of a company. A company can, for example, say, I have a project or a product or a service or an asset XYZ, and I would like to list this offer on the Future Multiverse Expo, then they can say, I would like to, they can look in the exhibition which land plot is still available or which exhibition booth is still available. And then they can say, I want to buy this. They can make an offer for buying this or for renting it for a certain time period, for a week, for a month, for 3 months, 6 months, or 12 months. And we are only going to lease land after our public launch. So it's only available still for a limited amount of time. And then we can digitize their offering, whatever it is, and we give the file to this company so that they fully own their own data, and then they can stream it to our platform like a hologram, basically. And they can disconnect it also at any time, then it disappears from the platform. So this has never been implemented in this way, that in a, especially in a hyper-realistic way, that a company can say, I am streaming a hologram of my physical real product, service, asset, or environment whatsoever to a platform that is accessible for anyone with one click through a chat, basically, in a 3D or a VR hyperrealistic way, where then somebody can say, great, I want to buy this, or I want to make an investment, or I want to refer this to someone who this could be interesting for. So it's basically an entire new economy through the browser, accessible for anyone, no matter where they are. And you can even access with when you have access to satellite internet. So we've basically built this in a way, the so-called Web4, which is the convergence of the IoT, Internet of Things, with AI, so AI integrated into processes of different kinds to smarten processes and faster and more efficient, plus blockchain for secure decentralized transactions of payments, but also as the next step, data, so actual decentralized data transactions in a secure way. We're not just creating a 3D VR environment of any kind, but a hyper-realistic one through the browser, decentralized, accessible, where data can be really decentralized, manageable. Massive opportunity, and it's easy to use for everyone. It's intuitive and it's simplified so that everyone can really get access to it, can use it, can have fun using it and really enjoy it. And at the same time, really use it to scale businesses and to really use it in a tangible economic way.
So I think the massive impact that Future Multiverse has, they implemented Web4 and as well Web5, if I see it's all decentralized possible. Yes, if you want to know more about all this, thanks to Simon for these massive answers. If you want to go to our website www.futuremultiverse.com and use our Grace AI, ask whatever you want and see what Web4 and Web5 is all about and see the opportunities that Future Multiverse offers to you. Thank you very much for today. And
thank you, Stefan.
To the next episode of Ask the Founder. Bye-bye.
Excellent. Thank you so much.